Happy St. Patrick's Day, everyone. Welcome to Long Beach State APE. Top of the morning. Hey, little leprechaun. Welcome. We have a really fun day planned out for you. We have lots of greats. We have dances. We have Wii tennis. We have Mario Fitness and many more. So a lot of good times here to be had. Our first teacher, Mr. Uriel, you may go ahead and take the screen.
Sounds great. Thank you, Dr. Winner.
All right. For today's lesson, we're going to be catching Pokemon using the underhand throw. So get ready because the Pokemon's up for grab today will be Pikachu, Charmander, and Squirtle. We're going to do a quick check-in, all right? So give me a thumbs up if you're feeling great today and you're ready to start. Give me a sideways thumb if you're feeling so-so, you're not very sure. Or give me a thumbs down if you're not feeling very well. Let's hope that you're all thumbs up and we are ready to start today's lesson. Parents, before we get started, can we please make sure that the area is clean, that there are no objects where your son or daughter may trip or fall? And let's also make sure that there is nothing that may shatter, because today we will be throwing a softball. Our equipment for today will be socks rolled up as a ball and a paper plate that is located 5 feet away. So parents, can you please go get this while we are warming up? Thank you. For our first exercise, we'll be doing a jumping jack. You're gonna jump, open your feet, tap with your hands, come back down, tap your feet, hands out to your side. For my student in the wheelchair, you're gonna clap on top and bring your hands back down. Once again, tap on top, bring your hands back down. We'll be doing this for 30 seconds. And I will give you the signal when to start.
All right, everyone can go ahead and start. Hey, great job, Candelario. I see you working hard. Michaela, I see you working hard. Marisol, great job. Good job. Clapping your hands on top and bringing them back down. Travis, great job. All right, everyone, freeze.
For our next exercise, I want everyone to do arm circles. Hands out to the side, and I want you to turn your hands to the inside. We're going to be doing this for 30 seconds. Wait for me to say go.
All right, everyone, go. Hey, good job, Matthew. Good job turning your circles. Emily, I see you. Great job. Keep turning, keep turning. Gary, I see you. Keep turning. Good job, good job. Ryan, I see you too. Good job turning your circles. Celine, I see you as well. Good job. Keep turning your circles. Keep turning your arms in a circle. Everyone, get ready and freeze.
This exercise, we're going to run in place. You're going to put your hands out in front. I want you to run as fast as you can. And for my students in the wheelchair, you're going to do air punches to the front. We're going to be doing this for 30 seconds. Wait for me to say go.
All right, everyone, let's get started. Travis, good job. I see you punching. Let's try to go a little bit faster. Come on, let's try to go a little bit faster, everyone. Good job, Dr. Binder. Keep your bringing your knees up high. Candelario, I see you. Good job working out. Keep bringing those knees up high. Connie, I see you as well. Everyone, freeze.
Now we're going to do body twists. I want you to put one of your hands on your chest. This hand's going to come out. and you're gonna twist. And then you're gonna switch, you're gonna twist. Switch, switch. I want you to do this for 30 seconds. Wait for me to say go.
Everyone go. Good job, Connie.
All right, I want everyone to do this with
me. I gotta go back. Good job, Sebastian. Keep training your body. Keep working out your back. Good job, Marisol. Good job training. Good job, Gary. Keep training your shoulders. Leonel, I see you. Good job training your body. Everyone freeze.
All right, I want everyone to do this with me. The cues we're gonna be practicing today are gonna be ready. You're gonna stand straight. You're gonna do wings. Your hands are gonna come out to the side and you're gonna turn and your throwing hand is gonna go down and up.
All right, and we're gonna do this for 30 seconds and we're gonna practice without anything in our hands for now. Ready, begin. Good job following through, Matthew. Sebastian, good job as well. You're following through. Emily, good job bringing your hands out to the side and following through with your right hand. Candelario, good job following through. Everyone freeze.
All right, so now we're going to go over all of our steps. We're going to put them in one. Make sure your plate is about 5 feet away. And remember, you're going to be ready. You're going to do wings, you're going to turn, and your throwing hand is going to go down and up. And when you release, make sure you are aiming for your plate. We're going to have about 60 seconds for this, so get ready and wait for me to say go.
All right, everyone, let's do the cues together. We have 60 seconds. Go. I see you. Good job. Following through and turning your body.
So now we get another try. If you thought this was hard, take 2 steps forward. If you thought it was kind of easy, take 2 steps backwards, or you can stay where you're at. But now, someone can help you. Your mom, your brother, your cousin, your uncle, whoever's around you can help you catch Pokemon.
All right, everyone, begin. Good job, Candelario. Connie, good job. I see you. Emily, good job following through. Gary, good job following through as well. Leo, good job following through. Connie, good job following through. Matthew, good job following through. All right, everyone freeze. All right, great job, everyone. You all caught a Pokemon. Now for your homework, what I want you to do is teach someone how to do an underhand throw using the cues that we learned today. So can someone tell me, anyone in any order, just tell me the cues, please. What were the cues that we learned today?
Wings,
all right.
Turn.
And
Down and up.
Down and up. All right. Great job, everyone. So now to check out, let me know how you are feeling about today's activity. Give me a thumbs up if you're feeling great about good about the activity. Give me a sideways thumb if you're not so sure, or a thumbs down if you didn't do that good.
What do you think?
Good.
All right. And this would be all for today. Thank you for joining me.
All right, nice start. Caught them all. Next up, Candelario.
Okay. Get my screen up. I think we're ready. All right, how's everybody doing? My name is Candelario. I'm gonna help you guys out and go through 8 rounds of kickboxing for fitness today. Our goal is gonna be to raise our heart rate, which is our most important muscle, our heart. And to begin, we don't need a lot of space, but we do need some open area, free from furniture, and you're able to move left and right, since we will be throwing some punches and maybe even throwing a kick here or there. All right. But before we start, I'd like to ask, how are we all doing today? I know it's St. Patrick's Day and I'm surely excited. I hope you guys are. How are we feeling? Thumbs up if you're good. Thumbs down. Oh, awesome. It's great. If you're thumbs down, okay, maybe we can work on it today. It's all right. Okay. So to begin, I'd like to help you guys out with our left and our right. We'll be throwing punches with our left. We have the left sign, so we can go to your left. You want to raise your left hand. It'll be up this side, according to the arrow on the screen. Your right hand, it's going to be the red arrow. It's going to be on this side. You have your right hand up. I'd like for you to put your hand on the left side of your chest and see if you can feel your heart. You guys can feel your heart beat? If not, that's okay. We're going to work on that today. All right. For our first round, we're going to go into the kickboxing gym. We're going to start some movement with our arms and our legs. This is the first part of the warm-up, and we'll do a marching in place, or if you're on a wheelchair, you pump your arms. Ready, begin. Excellent job, Quinn. I see you moving there. Way to pump those arms, Sebastian. Good movement, Emily. All right, Leo, I see you. Time. All right, are you guys ready for the next movement? On our next slide, we're going to do seated arm circles, or do the invisible jump rope. This is all still warming up for our next coming matches or next coming rounds. Ready and begin. Arm circles if you're seated, or the invisible jump rope. Great arm circle, Celine. I see you moving. Uriel, nice jumping there. You got a good rhythm. Stop. Good job, everyone. On our next exercise, we're going to do our right straight right punch. We're moving up now. hitting to the gym. If you're seated, we'll start with a right straight punch or a right leg kick. We're gonna go for 40 seconds. We're going into this bout against time. Ready? And
even with 6 feet apart,
begin.
Your generation still connected.
Good straight punches there, Uriel. Excellent leg extension, Connie. I see you moving your legs. Sebastian, I see you moving your right arm. Good job. Gauri, I see you moving your leg. Nice extension there. Well done, Ryan. I see you moving your arms. Excellent, Emily. I see you moving your arms as well, extending in the right hand. All right, raise that intensity. We're going up. Time. Let's move on to our next exercise for round four. We're doing a left leg kick. And if you're in a wheelchair, left straight arm punch. Ready and begin. Very well done, Michaela. I see you moving up there. Matthew, nice straight left arm. Nice extension, Leo. Marisol, I see you kicking that leg out. Good job. Good job, Dr. Binder. I see you moving. Almost there, a couple more seconds. Well, that's time. Good job. Let's move on to our next exercise. We're heading towards the last final rounds. Make sure we start raising that intensity level up. We're doing right hook and a right knee raise. If you're seated, we're doing the right hook and you're moving your arm in the letter shape of a U. Ready and begin. Good knee raises. I see you, Travis. Excellent hook. There's Sebastian moving your arm out and in. Uriel, I see you moving. Good job with the knee raises. Get those knees up. All right, that is time. Good job, everyone. Let's hit up the last final rounds. Now in the big spotlight. For this one, we're going to go with the left knee raise or the left hook for 40 seconds. Ready and begin. If you're in a wheelchair, let's lift left hook, swinging that arm out and in, making a U shape. If you're raising your knee, you want to get it up high, up to your chest. Good job, Dr. Binder. I see you raising your knee. Excellent, Connie. I see you raising your knee up to your chest. This is the last final rounds. Make sure it counts, people. Good job, everyone. Excellent hook there, Leo. Way to hook your left arm, Emily. Well done, Ryan. Time. All right, we're gonna combine some movements on this next round of our championship. If you're seated, we're gonna go with the left and right uppercuts. If you're standing, we're gonna be going with the left and right cross. And begin. On the left and right cross, you wanna go straight across and form the letter Z. Right arm extended out, and your back foot twisting. If you're doing the uppercut, you wanna push that hand all the way up. Good job, Matthew. I see you moving your arms in the uppercut motion. Gary, I see you doing those uppercuts. Awesome, Ryan. That is time. We're going with the final round. Let's give it all you got, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Let's do it with a left straight punch if you're seated. Left straight punch and a right hook. And if you're standing, we'll have to go with left and right kick. Good job, Quinn. I see you moving your arms. Excellent work. Connie, nice leg extensions with the left and the right. Last few seconds. You guys got this. Don't give up. Good uppercut, good hook. Sebastian, left straight and a right hook. And that is time. Good job. Well done, everybody. You guys did a lot of movement there. Our winner is you. You did it. Excellent. All right, our last few. I'd like to have you guys see if you can raise your right hand again and see if you can feel your heartbeat on the left side of your chest. Can you feel your heart? Thumbs up, yes. Thumbs down, maybe. All right, there's a question I'd like to ask everyone. What important muscle did we work out today?
Heart.
Yes. Right. And then what exercise made your heart beat faster? Was it kicking or was it punching?
What made your heart beat faster? Kicking or punching?
Kicking.
Yay. Did some kicking. Great. Great job, everybody. You guys did it. You guys are the champs now. You made it. And that'll do it for me. I'll see you guys next time. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
All right. Nicely done. Matthew is next.
All right, everyone, happy St. Patrick's Day and good afternoon. My name is Mr. Matthew, and today we will be doing an activity called Super Mario Fitness. So the materials you will need is two pairs of socks, one paper plate, and one piece of tape or a laundry basket. And this will be our target, and it will be 5 feet away. And let's do a check-in on how we are feeling right now. Are you feeling happy and excited, or sad and tired? So how's everyone feeling today? All right. So let's go on to the next slide. Let's warm up for our adventure. It is important to warm up our muscles so we don't get hurt. So Bowser stole our star, so let's go get it back. So let's walk in place so we can pump our arms. Let's do this for 30 seconds. Good job, Connie. Nice job, Lena. I like the effort, Candelario. Good going, Quinn. All right, let's go on to the next activity. So we're gonna hop on one foot, or we are gonna reach up. Let's get started. So the higher you reach up, you can just walk the front of it to the mountain. Versa. I like the effort, Sebastian. Keep it going, Travis. Nice job, Emily. All right, let's go on to the next one. Our next one is going to be arm twist. So we're going to extend our arms out forward and we're going to turn. Let's get started. Nice job, Leo. Good going, Ryan. Keep up the good work, Marcel. Nice job, baby. Great job, Quinn. All right, let's go on to the next one. All right, so this next one's gonna be arm reaches. So we're gonna be coming like we're extend our arms out forward. Nice job, Uriel. Good extension, Connie. Good going, Sebastian. I like the effort, Ryan. Keep it up. Nice job, Leo. All right, let's go on to the next one. So we're gonna be doing some trunk twists. Let's get started. Side to side. Good going, Connie. Great job, Emily. Keep it up, David. Nice job, Dr. Winner. All right, let's go to the next one. So let's extend around our hands out forward and flap our wings. Let's pretend like we're flying. Good job, Larissa. Great job, Marisol. Nice job, Michaela. All right, let's go on to the next. All right, so we have arrived at Bowser's castle. Let's get ready for a battle. So we're gonna practice our cues for throwing right now. Okay, so let's point side to target point and raise our thumb. Okay, we'll just practice these cues for a little bit. So side to the target point and raise our thumb. Nice job, Sebastian. Good form, Travis. Keep it up, Leo. All right, let's get to the next one. So our next cues is going to be to step and to throw. So let's practice this for another 30 seconds. I like the effort, Ryan. Keep it up. Great job, Celine. Good job, Brittany. All right. So before we get started, I'd like everyone to get your sock balls that we talked about at the beginning of our activity. And then I want you to imagine, is it going to be an ice ball or is it going to be a fireball? I'll let you choose. So is it going to be an ice or a fireball? Your choice. All right, once you've decided, let's get started. Let's practice. So make sure our target is about 5 feet away and let's practice our throws. Practice hitting your target as many times as you can. Let's remember our cues, side to target, point, one hit, step, and go. Great job, Travis. Nice job, Connie. Good going, Emily. Good work, Ryan. I like the effort, Leo. Nice throw, David. That's good technique, Vanessa. All right. Now that we've practiced, let's get ready for our final battle. So if that was too easy for you, I'd like you to step 2 feet back, or if it was a little bit hard, step 2 feet forward, okay? So let's get started. So as we can see, we see Bowser's health level. So the more you throw it, the more this is gonna go lower and lower. Nice job, Connie. I like the energy, Leo. Keep it up, Ryan. Good technique, David. Nice job, Marisol. Almost done, halfway there. Keep it up, Travis. Nice throw, Candelario. That's good technique, Yurio. Almost there. About 5 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time. All right. Great job, everyone. You guys got the star. All right. So let's do a really quick check for understanding. What are some cues for throwing? Who wants to share?
Point.
Yeah, that's one, Uriel. Nice job.
Step.
Step and throw. That's right. All right. And for our next question, how are you feeling today? So choose this, Mario, if you're feeling happy and excited, or if you're still feeling a little tired, choose this, Mario. All right, great job, everyone. Thank you for participating.
All right, thanks, Matthew. Nice work, all. We got our star back from that Bowser. Next up, we have Marisol.
Okay. Can you see my screen?
Yes, we see it. Just push the present button to get it in full mode. Yeah.
All right, everyone. Welcome to Bachata Boogie. First off, how are you feeling today? Give me a thumbs up in the chat, touch the screen, or you can, yeah. Or you can show me on your screen. Good job. Here's some rules. for dancing. You're gonna need some space in your living room or whatever room you're in for dancing. So a little space where you can dance a solo. I could not figure out how to get GIFs into my iMovie. I'm totally new at this. This is my first time ever doing something like this. So can somebody tell me what a solo is? You can say it out loud or put it in the chat.
By yourself?
Yes, a dance by yourself. So you're gonna see me doing the modeling of the solo, but I just couldn't get any of the GIFs in. So these are some examples of a solo dance. Here's some more examples. Here's some more examples. All right.
Hi everyone, my name is Marisol. Today we are gonna be learning La Bachata, which is a dance originally from the Dominican Republic. Now, have any of you ever learned a dance with four steps? Or four counts? Great. Well, if you have, you can apply it on here today. So let's begin with the counting. In bachata, we count with fours. So if everyone, my name is Marisol.
Oh, sorry. Today we're going to be learning.
Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes. That's it. Now I'm going to make it a little tricky. And we are going to swap out the word for the word tap. Okay, so repeat after me or say it with me. 1, 2, 3, tap. 1, 2, 3, tap.
Thank you, Brittany. I see you counting with me.
We're gonna put some styling into our hands. We're gonna take our hands like this and we're gonna put the middle fingers forward. Not inward, but forward. Try it. And the other hand, the other fingers are gonna fall where they may. And it always creates this interesting formation. And these are our styled hands for bachata.
Good job, right. Styling, Grady and Leonel.
Styling into our hands. We're going to use this for the next move. And you can do this three ways. You can do it seated, with a squat, or without a squat. I am going to demonstrate it with a squat. So what you're going to do is squat. And you're gonna take your hands up for a count of four slowly. And once you're up there, you're gonna bring your hands down for a count of four slowly. So it's gonna go squat, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you're going to release your hands and your squat and come down for a count of four. 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, squat, 1, 2, 3, 4. Four,
good job raising
release,
your hands, Larissa.
2, 3, 4. Now try it. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now that we've learned the counting, we're going to apply that to our legs and our feet. You ready? Okay, y'all. We are going to go to the right using our right foot. So watch me first. We're going to use that count of four or three in a tap. 1, together, 2, 3, tap. Again. 1, together, 2, 3, tap. Now you try. 1, 2, 3, tap. Yes. Now we are going to go the other way. So instead of your right foot, you're going to do it on your left foot, going to the left. Ready? 1, together, 2, 3, tap. Again. 1, together, 2, 3, tap. Now you try. 1, 2, 3, tap.
Great effort,
all right.
Michaela.
Now that we've gone from right to left and left to right, we are going to go forward and backward. Are you ready? Watch me demonstrate. 1, together, 2, 3, tap. Again.
Oh,
1, together, 2, 3, tap. 1, 2, 3, tap. Now we're going to go backward. 1, together, 2, 3, tap. Again. 1, together, 2, 3, tap. Again. One, two, three, tap.
Good job, good Sebastian. Job.
Now let's put this sequence together. So
sorry
we're
about
gonna
my
go
video not being
forward
split.
And then backward twice. Three, two, one, dance. One, two, three, tap. One,
good job,
two,
Urien.
Three, tap.
Great effort.
One, two,
raising your hand.
Three, tap. One, two, three, tap. Folks, we are going to put everything together into one dance sequence. You can do this standing with me, or you can do it seated. We're going to do the arms up and down twice. Then we're going to go from the right to the left, to the right to the left. Then we're going to go forward and backward twice. Ready? Three, two, one, dance. One, two, three, four.
I'm sorry,
one,
it's not showing
two,
the other
three,
screen.
Four. One, two,
good job,
three,
Connie.
Four.
Lifting
one,
your arms.
One, two, three, four. One, two, three, tap. 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 All right, we are gonna add some styling to our hips and or our shoulders. So you can do this seated or you can do this standing with me using your hips by bringing them side to side. Or we're going to do a figure eight. So you're gonna think about the number eight and we're gonna put that into our hips. Then we are gonna trace the number eight with our hips. Ready?
Oh, sorry, y'all. It keeps going to this one, but that's okay.
All right, we are going to add a bachata challenge movement. You don't have to do this. I hope you'll do it. You can observe, you can watch me demonstrate, and just do your best doing it with me. So instead of the one, two, three, tap, one, two, three, tap, we're gonna do this movement. You're gonna put one of your hands, this is my right, so your left, somewhere on your belly. You're gonna lift your other hand, put it in a 90 degree angle with a loose fist, and you're gonna open one, close two. Open three, tap four. Then we're gonna transition this hand onto the belly somewhere. This hand's gonna come up in a 90 degree angle with a loose fist. Same thing. One open, two close. Three open, four tap. Watch me. Three, two, one, dance.
I'm gonna just model this live, showing you the other way, showing you the standing way. Okay, if you can watch me. Ready? Three, two, one, dance. One, two, three, tap. One, two, three, tap. One, two, three, tap. One, two, three, tap. Good job, everyone.
One, two, three, tap. One, two, three, tap. One, two, three, tap. One, two, three, tap.
Next up is the long-awaited solo. You can do this to the beat of the music. You can do it to your own inner beat. You can not do it to any beat. You can do it however you want. Get creative. Go all out, let it out, close your eyes, whatever feels safe and good to your body. You're going to dance for 30 seconds to the music however you want, or again, not to the music. I'm going to share a few examples. So my video isn't showing. I'm going to look for it while the music's going, but y'all go ahead, ready? And dance. Good job, Matthew. Good job, Candelario.
All right, folks. We are going to apply all the movements we just learned into one dance sequence. You're going to use your hips, your figure eights.
Oops. I accidentally stopped it. I'm sorry. I'm having technological issues. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, everybody. We were going to do everything together with the bachata challenge, and I just am very untechnologically savvy, and I apologize. So I'm going to go back into my presentation. Okay. Which country did bachata originate from? The United States or the Dominican Republic?
Dominican Republic.
Good job, yes. Which one is most likely a solo?
Which one
is a solo? One. Yes. How many steps are in bachata?
Four.
Yes. Is bachata a type of dance or a game?
Dance.
It is a type of dance. I'm sorry, folks, about my technological mess up. How are you feeling? Good? Okay? Good. Not too good.
Good, good.
All right. Good job, everyone.
All right. Thank you for introducing a new dance to us. Next up, we have Jeremy.
Ooh. All right. Can we see my screen?
Thumbs yeah. up.
Yep. Awesome. Good afternoon, everybody. Today we're going to do a ski trip. My name's Jeremy. Who has been on a ski trip before? Can I get a woohoo or a thumbs up? Awesome. Well, today we're going to do some skiing for those who haven't. So, can I just get a quick thumbs up or thumbs down or middle thumb if you're how you're doing today? How you feeling? Ready to do a little workout?
Everyone,
awesome.
My name is Marisol.
Awesome. Can just get some room around you. If you are sitting down, that's fine as well. I will provide some modifications for those who will be seated. We're going to start with four warm-ups, and they're going to be 30 seconds each. This is just to get the blood pumping and circulating so that we don't risk injury. So get ready to start walking out to the ski lifts. Just picture walking out to the ski lifts, fresh snow. We can start walking in place. If you're sitting down, you can do some arm swings. Awesome job, guys. Taking our skis out to the lifts, getting ready to go down the slopes. Ready to pump those arms, Sebastian. Good job, Ryan. All right, next warm up, we're gonna go getting off the chairlift and on the chairlift. So just practice sitting up and down in your chair, or raise your hand like you're lifting the bar on the chairlift. Way to reach for the sky, Ryan. Good job, everyone. Okay, we're going into the next warm up. All right, we're getting down to the trail now. So just pretend you're squatting and holding your skis going down to the trail, or you can do some seated arm circles for balancing on your skis. See lots of arm circles. Good job, Connie. Good job, everyone. Awesome. Okay, last warm up. Pretend we're putting on our skis. Getting ready for the trail, warming up. Touch your toes. do some windmills or seated toe touches. Good job, Travis. Nice windmills. Good job, everyone. Okay, who's ready to go skiing? We're gonna do four more exercises. Each of them are gonna be 30 seconds each. Try to do as many of these exercises as you can in the 30 seconds. All right? We're gonna do some ski jumps or some seated side to side, depending if you're sitting down or standing up. We're gonna do this for 30 seconds. Just picture yourself dodging some trees. Going down the trail, there might be a tree on the slope, and you're just trying to avoid hitting any trees. Good job. All right, now we're gonna picture going off a jump. Do some squat jumps or some seated arm thrusts if you're sitting down. I see your arm thrust, David. Awesome job, everyone. All right, next one. We're gonna go into squats and seated forward trunk bends. Picture just ducking for a branch. If a branch of a tree, you're gonna duck and try to miss that tree branch. Good job, guys. Way to squat, Emily. Marissa, good job, good form. Try to get that 90 degree angle on your squats if you can. All right. Last one, we're gonna do some side shuffles. Picture going as fast as you can down the slope. Finish off with some speed. Nice trunk twist, Uriel. Awesome job, everyone. All right, we're gonna go through each of these four one more time so that we get that exercise that we need. All right, we're going back to the ski jumps. Remember, we're dodging trees. 15 more seconds. Good job, Ryan. Way to do some side to side. See a lot of great ski jumps. All right. We're going back off the jump. Picture going off the ski jump. Awesome squat jumps, Michaela. Great job, Brittany. Awesome. All right, back into the squats. Picture ducking for the branch. Try to get that 90 degree angle when you're doing your squats. Good job, everyone. Awesome. Last one. Fast as you can. We're trying to get down to the lodge. End of the ski trip. We're almost there. Great side shuffles, Travis. 3, 2, 1. Great job, everyone. Okay, so can someone give me their favorite exercise that we performed today?
Ski jump. Either
down in the chat.
Side shuffle.
Side shuffle. Okay, so was picturing ducking for a branch or quick fall down a cue that we learned today?
Ducking for a branch.
Ducking for a branch.
Awesome. Thank you, guys. And just give someone around you a virtual high five. Finish off. Great job, everyone.
Right. Thank you, Jeremy, for taking us on the ski trip. And to finish us off today, we have Connie with some Wii tennis.
Okay. Hello, everyone. My name is Connie, and today we will be playing some Wii tennis. But before we begin, make sure that you all have enough space for movement. Ask for help if you need, and always try your best and have fun. Let's start off with a warm-up. We're going to be either doing jumping jacks or, if you're sitting down, overhead claps. Ready, begin. Condolario, good job on the overhead claps. Larissa and her brother, good job doing the jumping jacks. Sebastian, good overhead claps. Keep going, everyone. Okay. Time's up. Next, for the next, before we move on, for every warm-up you guys, everyone completes, you're gonna get 1 point. So the first point you got was 15, and that is equal to 1 point. So in tennis, 1 point equals 15. For the next warm up, we're going to be doing arm circles and try to switch to going backwards when the timer hits 15. Uriel, good job on your forward arm circles. Michaela, good arm circles. Emily, Leo, Ryan, good effort. Brittany, good job. 10 more circles. 5 more seconds. Okay, so you got 1 more point. That's 2 points, and that equals 30. Okay, for the next warm-up, it's going to be either calf raises if you're standing up and shoulder shrugs if you're sitting down. Ready, begin. For the shoulder shrugs, make sure to bring your shoulders all the way up to your ears. Sorry, Celine, Travis, Sebastian, good job. Nice shoulder shrug. Brittany, good job on your calf raises. 10 more seconds. Okay. So 3 points, that's 40, and we have one more. You're either going to be doing high knees or leg extensions. Ready, begin. Make sure when you're doing high knees, bring your knees all the way up to the chest. And when you're doing leg extensions, bring your leg all the way to 180, a straight leg. Michaela, Dr. Vintner, good job on your high knees. Travis, I like the way you're pumping your arms. Okay, time's up. 4 points, that equals game. You won one game in tennis. Okay, now we're going to be moving on to learning the different shots in tennis. We have forehands, backhands, volleys, and serves. So let's start off with the forehands. For this, you're gonna wanna turn to the right side of your right side, have your dominant hand, which most people are going to be right-handed, down, and then bring it up all the way over your left shoulder. Ready, begin. Sebastian, good job. Make sure that you're going from low to high. Leo, Emily, good job. Uriel, good forehand. Okay. Nice. You guys got 1 point again, so that's 15. Moving on to backhand. For this, you want to use your two hands now, and you're going to turn to the left side of your body. Start low again, just like the forehands, and swing all the way to the right side of your shoulder. Ready, begin. Matthew and Michaela, good job. Everyone's doing really well. Keep going. Okay, time. Now let's move on to volleys. So for volleys, this is what you do when you're up at the net, and you're just gonna have your dominant hand up and pretend like you're giving someone a high five. Ready, begin. Make sure to extend all the way out, like you're giving someone a high five. Good job, Condolario. David, Brittany, I like the effort. Five more seconds. Okay, good job. Okay, for the final shot, it's gonna be the serve, and this is what you do when you're starting the point off. Just like volleys, you wanna have your dominant hand up, but for this, you wanna reach up to the sky and then pretend like you're swatting a fly and finish off with across your left side of your shoulder. Ready, begin. Travis, Celine, Brittany, your serves look good. Ryan, good job. Leo, good job. Michaela, try to finish across the left side all the way down. Yeah. Good job. Now, before we move on to a fun game, let's answer some questions. So what would the score be if you won 2 points? Is it A, 15, B, 30, C, 40, or D, game? You can also give me with your fingers. Yeah, I see the two. It's 30. Good job. Okay, next question. What kind of stroke is this in tennis? Is it an A, forehand, B, backhand, C, serve, or D, volley?
Forehand.
Good job. Yeah, it's a forehand. Okay, now let's move on to the fun game. We're going to be playing Wii Tennis. So for this, we're going to be the two people in the front closest to us. So you can either choose the person at the end of the line or the person in front of the net, which is going to be the volleyer. If you're at the front, you're only going to be doing volleys. But if you're at the back, you're going to be doing some serves, forehands and backhands. Or if you want, you can pretend to be both of them, whatever you're most comfortable with. Ready? So start off with the serve and reach up high all the way. Good. Remember, make for the volleys, pretend you're giving someone a high five. Backhand, good. Another volley. Nice, you got 1 point. So it's 15. Good serve. Nice volley. Remember, backhand, two hands. Good, volley, nice. So 2 points. Start off with a serve. Good. Good volley. Nice. Okay, one more point and you win the game. Serve. Nice. Backhand. Good backhand. Good volley. Get ready for the backhand. Nice. Forehand, good. Let's finish strong. Nice backhand. Good volley. Nice, you all won the game, good job. Okay. Let's all come back to our seats. How does everyone feel after our lesson? Good, thumbs up, neutral, or sad? Good, I see a lot of thumbs up, that's good. I had a lot of fun teaching you guys. I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and let's end with giving everyone a virtual high five. Thank you.
All right, nicely done to our teachers today. Thank you all for joining us on this St. Patrick's Day. This class will be back next week at 1 o'clock. You can also join us Tuesday and Thursdays at 3:45 for our APE cohorts, which are teaching. Thank you all. Thanks for working hard. Till next time.